most of them are stolen. I got small hands, but that just don't mean nothing anymore. Hey guys, what's up? Just wanted to talk to you for a few minutes on just some things going on the channel. Over the past few weeks, I've had some exciting things happen, and I just wanted to share them with you. About a month ago, maybe 6 weeks ago, I'm not sure, I applied for a brand ambassador deal with a bike company. And I never expected that I would actually be accepted. That wasn't even part of my thought process, like what to do if I got accepted. Just never thought it would happen. And I finally got an email from them, and I really just thought it was just gonna be a rejection email, but when I read it, I was actually accepted into their program. So I got a deal to be a brand ambassador for a bike company. And I admit, I was totally stoked. It was awesome. I couldn't believe that somebody was giving me a chance. They loved my enthusiasm, they loved my application letter, and wanted to work with me, and I was pumped. But the more I looked at the deal, with a brand ambassador deal, it's not like a sponsorship, right? And I mean, with a sponsorship, maybe they're giving you free product and paying you maybe even. And not that I would expect this for a YouTube channel, I mean, especially with only 1,400 subscribers. But with this brand ambassador deal, I would get a discount, a really good discount, mind you, on their bikes. But it would limit me to only being able to ride their bikes. So what that would entail would be me selling the Roscoe and the Rain, just because realistically I couldn't afford to keep them and buy two new bikes or one new bike, whatever it would be to replace it. So when I really sat down and did the numbers, and plus the fact I kind of do genuinely like my two bikes, and it would have to be a heck of a deal for me to get rid of them. I mean, ideally I'd love to keep, especially the Roscoe. I mean, that's sort of my gateway drug into this whole sport, and it'd be hard for me to get rid of that bike, to be honest. So anyways, looking at the numbers, just not sure it was gonna make sense for me financially. I mean, by the time I sell my bikes and buy their bikes and all that, I'd probably be in the hole, and I'm not really sure that made sense for me at this point in the channel's life. Sure, it would've been cool. I mean, I would've loved to say, hey guys, I'm working with this bike company, we're gonna be building up some bikes and all this stuff, and maybe, you know, doing some stuff with them, and it would've been cool, don't get me wrong, and I'm still, pumped that I had the opportunity, but at the end of the day, I just don't think I'm gonna be able to do it. It just doesn't make sense. Just wanted to share that with you guys, because I was super excited about it, don't get me wrong. But we have some other cool things going on with the channel. We have Fun MTV. They've will be a sort of little sponsor of the channel, I guess. Sending me some stuff to review, which I appreciate immensely. Check out the Roscoe there. It's got some new bars and stem on it. Fun MTV, if you check them out, funmtv.com. Like it says, hashtag keeping it fun. And also PNW Components, gonna be doing some work with them, and possibly a wheel manufacturer, although details of that I haven't been ironed out completely, but I have an idea for a video series I wanna do, and a wheel manufacturer would be super, super sweet to come on board. Oh, so for some travel plans this year, actually in a couple weeks, I'm going back down to the States, gonna be going to Asheville and Tennessee. Gonna be doing Bailey Mountain Bike Park and Windrock. I don't know why I kind of stumbled on that. I've been there before and it's awesome. Maybe meeting up with some YouTubers down there, doing a little bit of a collaboration. Hopefully that works out. I'm not really 100% sure if it will, but it'd be cool if it did. Cough, biking with Bobo. Anyways. And then in the summer, I have some plans or talks to go over to BC to Whistler and Squamish with Canadian MTB YouTube channel. Anthony there, we've talked, and that'd be super awesome. I mean, going out to BC is a whole new world, and I'd love to be able to go out there and see what they have to offer out there for riding. And then in the fall, I've been talking to Good Trails YouTube channel. If you haven't checked out his channel, you should, because he's got kind of a cool take on YouTube videos, and we've talked about doing something in Quebec. So hopefully that works out, and we can get as many people as we can out to that. And then just kind of some local stuff, the Tuggy Hauser Spring Ride. I'm thinking of trying to do that the same day as the spring kicker at Turkey Point. So I believe that's April 14th or 15th. I just think it'd be a great opportunity to do it along with them, just to, you know, we get more people out, get to interact with their club a bit, spread the word about the channel. We can, you know, network with all their guys out there. So that's the tentative plan for that. We'll figure that out here in the next few weeks or so, because right now we're not riding anything anytime soon right now, or nothing with regular bikes. So speaking of all this sort of travel and stuff, I have set up a Patreon page. If you go to patreon.com/ToogieHauserMTB, I have set that up, and it's just a way to support the channel. I mean, I'm just asking for like $2 a month or $5 a month or whatever. I mean, it's like literally less than a cup of coffee or less than a beer a month. And it's just showing that you guys support what I'm doing. I want to keep making these videos. I want to keep doing this. And I'd love to just travel more and get to more places and meet more people and collaborate with different channels and just create more and better diverse content. And you guys becoming Patreons or supporting the channel any way you can just makes that happen. In closing, I guess, you know, we got 1,400 subscribers now, or just over 1,400 subscribers on the channel. It's been about a year since the channel launched. We're gonna be doing a live stream this Thursday, which will be the exact 1 year anniversary of the channel. So March 7th, 2019 will be 1 year since the channel started, and we'll do a live stream. You guys can ask me anything. We can talk about bikes, summer plans, travel plans, riding together, anything you guys want to talk about, we can talk about it. I'm going to try to maybe have a special guest on the live stream. We'll see if that'll work out. I just wanted to share with you guys because it's been exciting for me. I won't lie. I've been super pumped to say I was a brand ambassador for a bike company, but just not sure that's going to happen. So again, guys, just thank you from the bottom of my heart for all the support you've shown me on the channel. And I'm just going to keep trying to give you guys great content, and just keep it on going. So again, guys, don't forget, make sure you subscribe to the channel, like the videos, and as always, keep your feet on the pedals. Right, Pickles? We have to keep our feet on the pedals, don't we, buddy? This is my fat little puggy buddy. I was thinking, I was telling my kids we should get like a little basket on the front of the bike and put him in a little robe with a little hood over his head, and he looked just like E.T. You guys imagine Pickles on the front of my bike in a little basket? What do you think, Pickles? Anyways, guys, thanks again. Hope to see you soon. I got big plans, most of them are stolen. I got small hands, but that just don't mean nothing. I got big plans, most of them are stolen. I got small hands, but that just don't mean nothing anymore. Oh, shut your face, Toogie Hauser!